So we are here at the Nove Mesto round of the World Cup. That's the third round of the XC World Cup, and we're here in the pits to check out some of the very best XC tech. Let's go and have a look. So we're here at Nove Mesto, and we're actually a bit early. As you can see, there's not an awful lot going on in the background, so we're just snooping around the pits to see what XC tech we can find. And especially those guys here, but I just want to show you something. I'm a bit envious of this tool kit spotted down the back here. This is Major League Tool Envy. Have a look at that. So something's pretty cool here to see at Nove Mesto is the fact that the tubeless ready sealant for Specialized is now actually available. This is the stuff that we saw in the prototype stage at the first round of the World Cup at Stellenbosch in South Africa. Now all the team riders have been using this stuff on all of their bikes, and one of the aims of this is it's totally non-toxic and it doesn't congeal like other tubeless sealants do on the market. So one of the things that's especially useful about this is it's especially good in hot conditions. We know that already because of the testing they did in Africa, but it's designed to not congeal, not dry up, and generally just last better on the tyre. And it completely seals the inside of the tyre, much like those sort of latex style sealants do. It definitely is aiming to last longer. And there's also a whole new range of tyres from Specialized, starting at the lightest XC tyre they have, which is just 511 grams there for the 2.1 in the Renegade. And they go all the way through up to the Ground Control, which is a sort of heavier duty tyre that's better for roots, rocks, and when the conditions are a bit more adverse. The tyre I want to talk to you about is actually the Fast Track. So this is a tyre that's existed in the range for some time, but it's actually got some new improvements on there. Now the rubber is their Gripton rubber, which we know that is very good in all conditions. It's very good on wet rock, it's good on wet roots, but it's also quite good in dry and rolls fast too. They've actually kept the carcass the same size, but the actual tread itself, the shoulders are a little bit wider spaced than on the previous tyres. So it's got a bit more support there. And also the knobbles themselves are a little bit further apart, which does mean it's going to clear mud better. So improvements from Specialized on the tyre front, that's available in 2.1 and 2.3. And interestingly, it's available in 26-inch, 27.5 and 29-inch wheels there. So something for everyone. I've just stumbled across a Cannondale stand with, of course, that new Lefty Ocho single crown fork. But instead of me waffling on about it, I'm going to take you to someone who's even more enthusiastic than me. This is Lefty Larry. Let's go meet the man. Okay, so we're in the Cannondale pits here at Nove Mesto with Lefty Larry, and we're going to take a look at this brand new single crown Lefty Ocho. Now, I'm going to leave it to you to take us through the best features of this fork from the top down, because it's a pretty special fork.
Okay, first of all, I'm really excited I'm here to present it, because Lefty Ocho, development of 3 years, is probably our masterpiece so far. I've been with Lefty since day one, but I'll take you down from the top, okay? So a little bit of comparison to the old system, we went to a single crown versus double crown. It's stiffness tuned, so it's stiff enough, it's stiffer than competition, but just the right amount of stiffness, let's say this way. Tapered head tube, 1/8 half inch. External compression adjustment, cable actuated lockout. You go down, industry, I want to say, benchmark cable brake line routing with a guide guard. Going down to a travel sag and travel indication plus full travel with the indicator O-ring. Then we got a what we call a stop lock system to remove the caliper. Very easy, self-centering caliper system. And then we got a very beautiful 23-click, fully functional rebound, which allows riders from 40 kilos to 145 kilos to get the perfect setup. Besides that, we have a sidecar valve, which makes access a lot easier. Plus, there's no chance of contaminating your rotor with any lubrication, and a lot easier to mount the pump and inflate your fork.
I know in particular, this is one of your favorite parts of the fork. Absolutely. Just tell us a bit more about this cable routing, because this is one of the cleanest I've seen.
Yeah, what's key with the cable routing between the brake caliper and the guide guard, the brake line should be fixed so it can't touch the inner leg or the outer leg or the spokes, of course. So we clamp the brake line right here, and that's fixed and stays. Then we have a C-tube which supports the brake line all the way up, and there's another shoe up here that guides the brake line, motocross style. Plus, it will not touch the chassis or the frame in any way. So super clean, super sexy. Plus, the part is very structural. It's made of carbon fiber, so it's also light.
Okay, so while we've got it here as well, let's have a look at the unique brake mount, because in the past, previous Lefty forks, you had to kind of fiddle with the caliper and take the caliper off in order to get the wheel off in a fast.
Keep in mind, on if you get a flat, you don't have to remove the wheel. You can just pull the tire off
because
it's single-sided. But yes, if you have to transport, if you have a wheel change, you do have to remove the caliper. So what we've done here, we've taken what we call the stop lock system. Oops, sorry. It's basically a brake mount that you just need a 5mm Allen key, and you rotate, you push the stop lock button, and you rotate about 180 degrees, and the whole system just with the caliper just comes off. As you can see, these conical studs mean it's self-centering. So when I put it back on, I don't have to fiddle. It just goes straight in. You put your Allen key back on. Sorry, a little bit. Okay, and you turn 180 degrees until the pin clicks.
Amazing. And okay, obviously one of the biggest points of this is it's a single crown fork. The prior forks with the Lefty design had a twin crown system. And whilst it worked well, there are also issues with fitting different bikes and all sorts of other limitations. So this is just a 100mm XC fork.
Maybe that needs to be said. Lefty Ocho is a non-compromised 100mm cross-country fork only. So any questions, can I get more travel out of it? Not intended and not possible, because any excess material for more travel would be more weight, and you would need to beef up the structure to allow to do that. So no compromise, 100mm cross-country only.
So there you go. So Larry's taken us through that brand new single crown Lefty Ocho, which is certainly one of the lightest XC 100mm forks available at the moment. Unfortunately, unless you're buying a Cannondale, you won't be able to have this on your bike until 2019. So either get saving or get a Cannondale. So just here at the Kross stand at the moment, just checking out some very cool new XC tech, which you're going to see very soon. But I just wanted to draw your attention to the tyre that Yolanda Neff used at the Abstad race, because a lot of people have been asking about it. So although it sounds like it was a mud tyre, this is it here. And actually, it's deceptive. There's not that much tread on it. It has certainly got a more raised tread profile than the sort of fast rolling tyres, which are the sort of de rigueur in cross-country racing. But you can see why this tyre works so well for her. Of course, you can't doubt her skill on a bike, was at the end of the day what made her take that race. Of course, there's the Mitas Hyperion tyre, but the thing that's important about this is the compound on it. So this is a CRX light compound, and you might think that it's a really soft compound, but it's actually not that soft. And of course, as we know for like mud riding, the tyre actually needs to hold its shape and cut in a lot more. So having a harder compound is actually to the benefit there. And you can see that is exactly what did the trick. And as you might have noticed, I'm sat right here behind the brand new Kross full suspension bike. So this is the first from these guys, and this is known as the Rd3. This one is a prototype, so there are changes coming before the production one, which will be available in autumn this year. Now, this is a size small. This particular one belongs to Maja Wyszlowska, and up front here is running a 68.5 degree head angle, which is actually quite extreme for the cross-country bikes. Some of the other bikes we've been looking at are nearer to the 70 degree mark, so it just shows that where cross-country is likely to go in the next few years. Of course, you might have noticed as well, there's a big drop post on here, 125mm drop. It's quite a lot more than a lot of the other riders are choosing to run. So yet again, it's another hint about what cross-country is going to be doing. So the frame, full carbon, it's got a single pivot. This is their new efficient single pivot system. Out back, it doesn't have a pivot. It relies on the natural flex of the carbon. It's a very neat system, and we have seen other brands also not using pivots out back, and it works really, really well. It's even a carbon rocker link on there, and on this particular bike, it's actually a prototype DT shock with slightly different cable routing to what you're going to see in a production one. On this one, it's a bit of a strange loop that comes around to the top for the lockout operation there, but on production, it's just going to come neatly up from the bottom, so that is going to be a different unit on there. Of course, this is one of the team racing bikes. It's running the full Shimano XTR setup, although this one does actually have an XT cassette out back, so it's got a slightly wider range of gearing on there. DT Swiss fork up front, the carbon XRC wheels with those 25mm rims, and of course it's one of those Mitas tyres that a lot of people are certainly talking about now since Yolanda's win last weekend. But have a look at that, that's a first, and it's very, very cool. Okay, so we're checking out the XC Tech here at Nove Mesto, and of course looking at none other than Nino Schurter's race bike, which has some very special parts on it, including this. I'm actually not allowed to touch the shifter, and I can tell you I really want to have a little feel to see what it's like. Of course, it's their new Eagle ETAP wireless shifter. It's controlling a completely wireless 12-speed derailleur at the back of the bike, and what I can see here is it takes the CR2032 battery there, and it attaches to the bars using the regular sort of mounting. But interestingly, it's got a multi-use sort of lever here. It looks like you can operate this with your finger and your thumb simultaneously to shift both up and down. It's a very cool looking bit of kit, and we will be able to get our hands on one of these soon. But at the moment, I'm gonna have to just obey Yannick the mechanic and not touch it, even though I really, really wanna touch it. Now, this is the latest version of that SRAM ETAP Eagle wireless rear derailleur that we've seen. The earlier one that we saw was bearing the black box markings on it, but this looks far more like a production offering to me. You see the battery unit that plugs into the back there. Of course, it uses SRAM's proprietary wireless system, but that is all that we really know about it until it is officially launched. But get a load of that. It's certainly looking a lot more sleek in all black. I found personally it looked a little bit bulky perhaps before in the twin colour, but actually in black it looks really, really good.
So I'm just checking out the brand new XTR Trail transmission here. So that's the 1x12 system. Check how impressive this cassette is. So this cassette uses a specific rear hub. You can't use this on any existing Shimano hub. It's a micro spline system. We've got some images of that, but obviously you can't see that right here. But check how silent this is. Virtually makes no sound at all. Some people like the sound of an expensive rear hub, but a lot of racers have been complaining that it's actually quite distracting in certain situations. Up front, you can see that there's a 1x specific system now. The cross-country guys get the option of having a 2x crank on the front there, but they don't get the option of this monstrous 1051 cassette. So there's also a 1045, so you can choose between the two if you're running 1x. If you're running 2x, you have to run that 1045. Why did they go for the 1051? Basically, just to get the smoothest possible transition between all that gearing. And from my point of view, I think this looks absolutely stunning. And look at the rear derailleur as well. There's two options of those, one to cater for the 2x system and one, of course, for the 1x. So as I previously mentioned, there are two versions of the brakes available, the race and the trail. Of course, they've got that same finish on them, the stunning finish you only get on the XT Racing transmission there. The difference being the trail versions, of course, are four-pot brakes. They've got four pistons in them for that increased braking power that is needed by endurance and all mountain riders. The race brakes, a lot more slender looking than these, just have two pistons, which seems to be plenty for modern cross-country riding and racing. So the brake lever design is actually improved now as well. And as you can see, there's two contact points on the actual handlebar. So as well as being able to lose weight off the lever, they actually make it stiffer and far more sort of sturdy on the handlebars as it's supported in those twin positions. And as I said before, the iSpec mount now is fully adjustable, so you can get those shifters exactly where you want them. So as you can see here, we have the XTR race brake caliper here. It's far more slender than that trail option. Of course, the trail option is still quite sleek as far as brake calipers go, but look how minimalist the race one is there. And of course, that's a tiny little 140mm rotor there, very popular with the XC crowd, but still makes the most of that Icetech technology. The hub design, again, caters specifically for that 12-speed cassette. In this case, this one is the 45 on here rather than the 51 that we've just seen on the enduro bike.
So there we go. That is some of the coolest XC tech we found at round three here in Nove Mesto. Let us know in the comments below what your favorite bits of tech are. We'll fire up a bit of a conversation about it. For a couple more great GMBN tech videos, click down here at the bottom for our trailside maintenance. The sort of stuff that happens when you don't pay attention to what's going on with your bike and you just go out riding and something goes wrong. Something there for everyone, I think. And click down here if you want to see a really cool pro bike. It's a Cannondale Scalpel, custom painted for Manuel Fumic, the German XC racer. And of course, as always, click on that round globe to subscribe. We've got new content for you every week here at GMBN Tech. And as always, if you like the video, give us a thumbs up.